I'm Wills Elliman of Newmark Knight Frank. Today we're having a conversation with Mark Turner of WSFS Bank in Wilmington, Delaware.
So for many, many years, we were not an acquisitive organization. We thought our competency was around organic growth. So one associate at a time, one customer at a time, maybe a team at a time. But post-financial crisis, so post-2007, 2008, the opportunities in the marketplace became more around acquiring other institutions. Institutions that were not necessarily troubled, but may have had a hard time making it on their own with a slow economy and a lot of regulatory burden. So we did 6 acquisitions in about a 3-year span, 3 of them in the traditional banking space, one in Delaware, 2 in southeastern Pennsylvania, which provided us a nice heft in southeastern Pennsylvania. And then we did 3 in the non-traditional space, so a mortgage banking company and 2 wealth management firms. So as we look at our strategic plan, as a bank that's about, that right now is the oldest and largest bank headquartered in the Delaware Valley, and that's the Philadelphia, Camden, Wilmington metropolitan statistical area, and that's the 6th largest MSA in the country. We see our growth plans being about half and half, about half through organic growth, which we're still very good at, and half through acquisition opportunities, which we've developed a competency around over the last decade or so. We're 185 years old, but as I say, it's our responsibility as a 185-year-old institution to reinvent ourselves every generation to stay relevant for that generation and the next generation. So we have a history of innovation in our organization that goes back a long way. In the early 70s, we were either the first or the second bank in the United States to introduce a debit card. So that's access to your checking account through a piece of plastic in your wallet. Prior to that, you accessed your checking account through either a check or going to the teller line. It was a major, major innovation that still obviously exists today and is very, very widely used today. In the late 90s, we engaged in another series of innovative activities. So got deeply involved in internet banking when it started to become very popular in the late 90s through an investment in a company called Everbank, and that name still exists today, and we helped get that organization off the ground. And we're one of the few banks that had a significant investment in a separate company that all they did was internet banking. We also got in the mid-90s involved in reverse mortgages. That's a product that was just starting that time, and we were a significant buyer and a significant part of the liquidity of providing reverse mortgages in the United States in its early part of its infancy. That product has developed quite a bit, has changed quite a bit, but that product's still a very, very useful product today. In fact, my dad is in the process of taking out a reverse mortgage. And then we also got involved in mortgage banking on a national level through a startup, and also got involved in ethnic banking. So a bank called United Asian Bank, where we served Korean American communities or Asian American communities that, you know, pop up in certain places, and obviously there's a desire, they have very, very strong communities, and there's a desire for them to be served by banks in their local communities, by people who speak the language with the materials and products that speak to the needs of those communities. So that takes us up through kind of the early 2000s, kind of pre-financial crisis, pre-regeneration of the financial industry, which is, you know, fintech, which is where we are today.